In this video, we'll work on the cartoon character in Photoshop. The exported Illustrator passes will either be in layer or in groups. First, we'll merge the groups. Right-click on the group and choose Merge Group. Then, we will remove the extra line art. Press Z for the zoom tool, zoom in, and then press the space bar to scroll. Press L and choose the polygonal lasso tool. Select the areas to be removed. So just click and select and come back to the original starting point. Click and complete the selection. So this part of the line art belongs to the head layer. So press delete to remove it. Press spacebar and then scroll and move to the next area. Press L again. Choose the area of the line art to be removed. Double click to close the selection. This extra line art belongs to the body layer. So choose the body layer and press delete. Press the spacebar, move to the next area. Press L for the lasso tool. And then choose the area to be removed. Press delete. Zoom out. All of the extra areas has been removed. Go to the menu and choose Merge Visible. Label this line art. Lock the transparency and lock the position. And then also lock the entire layer. Press W for the magic wand tool. Select the nose area. Press Shift, then select an area far away from the nose area, like the ear. Then choose the tail. Then choose the front leg. So these areas are far apart from each other. That makes it easier to work on. Create a new layer. Move it down. Label this nose, ear, tail, and front leg. This next step is very important. Press Z, zoom in to this area. The magic wand selection, select all the way to the edge of the line art, leaving a little gap between the selection and the line art. So you do need to close that gap. So this step is very important. Select, modify, expand at least 1 pixel. Okay, and you see that now the selection move below the line art. This step is very important. Zoom out, edit, fill 50% gray. Okay. Lock the transparency and lock the position. Deselect. The next area, press the W for the magic wand tool again. Go back to the line art layer, select the head, press Shift to select the front leg and select the hind leg. These three areas are also far apart, so that makes it easier to work on these areas. Create a new layer, move it down below the line art, label this head, front leg, back leg. Select, modify, expand 1 pixel. Okay. It is very important to expand the selection by 1 pixel. Edit, fill, 50% gray, okay. Lock the transparency and lock the position. Select, deselect. Go back to the line art layer, press W and select the body. Select, modify, expand 1 pixel. Create a new layer, move it down below the line art. Label this body. Edit, fill, 50% gray. Lock the transparency, lock the position. Deselect. Now all of the areas are blocked in. Next, press O for the dodge and burn tool. Click and select the burn tool. Select the nose ear layer. We will work on the nose first. Size the burn tool up. Approximately the size of the nose. The exposure by default is at 50%. Press 1 for 10% and gradually darken the nose little at a time. We can move on to the ear. Darken the shadow side, going over several times. Size this down so I can go over this area several times. Move on to the tail. For the tail, I need a larger brush tip. Size it up and then burn in the shadow area. The next area will be the front leg. I need to make this a little bit larger to get a smoother gradation. The next area I want to work on is going to be the head. For the head, I need to size the brush tip up much larger to get a smoother gradation. So move this over several times. Now I want to work on the snout. Reduce the size of the brush tip and just glide over several times to darken this area. The next area on the same layer is the hind leg. Size the brush tip up a little. Darken the shadow side to the similar degree as the other area. The front leg. Move on to the body. For the body, I will size the brush tip up much larger to get a smooth gradation for this part first. And then size it down slightly for the midsection. Darken the front section. Darken the midsection a little bit more. The head is going to cast the shadow on the body. So I will size this down and then darken this area. So now all of the shadow shadings are done. Let's switch over to the Dodge tool. By default, the exposure is at 50%. Press 1 to change it to 10%. Choose the nose layer, size this down, and then add some highlight. Next will be the ear, size this down, and then add some highlight. Enlarge the size, and then add some highlight. Next will be the tail, so size this down slightly. The next area on this layer is going to be the front leg. Size this up, and then add some highlight. Choose the head layer. For the snout area, I need a much larger brush size. Just add a little bit of highlight. Then size this up again and then add a little bit of highlight to the overall head. Size this down to add some highlight to the mouth area. Then let's move on to the hind leg. Size this way up and then add some highlight. Size this down. Add some highlight to the front. So the next area will be the body. So choose the body layer. Once again, size this up. Add a little bit of highlight here. Add a little bit of highlight here until it looks three-dimensional. So now most of the shadings are done. Next, create a color layer. Go back to the line art. Press W for the magic wand tool. This time, I will select the outside of the line art. Then, select, modify, expand. This time, I will choose 2 pixels. OK. Zoom in, and you can see this expand the selection under the line art. Since the outside area is selected, select inverse. So now I select the entire character. Create a new layer and change the blend mode from normal to color. Label this color. Lock the position. Choose a color. OK. Edit, fill. Choose the foreground color. OK. Using the color layer is one way to add color. I will show you another way. So let's turn off the color layer. Come down here and then choose Hue Saturation. So this will create an adjustment layer. Choose Colorize. Now I can choose different color hues using the first slider. I can choose the different saturation using the second slider. And then now you can choose the brightness or darkness using the third. This is a much more flexible way of choosing color. Maybe this color, a little bit less saturation. That looks pretty good. Next, I will show you how to add ambient color. Press P for the pen tool. Click and drag here, click and drag here, and then cover the entire right side of this character. To here, so just click and drag. Come back to the original starting point, click and drag. Next, click and drag here, and then choose the right side of the nose, including a little bit of the snout, including a little bit of the head in this area. Come back and complete this path. Add another one approximately to this leg area. Click and drag. Now I have these passes. Come over here, click, create another hues and saturation adjustment layer. Click colorize. Now I add an ambient color to the right side of this character. Increase the saturation a little bit more. I can change the color to maybe a purplish color. This gives a very sharp edge. In the property, click the mask area. This will allow me to change the softness of the ambient light edge. So I'll choose maybe 60 pixel. Click on the passes, press A for the direct selection tool. I can readjust the ambient light area. It looks pretty good. Next, I will create a secondary ambient light for the front area. Press P for the pen tool. Deactivate all of the layer. I'll create a pass for the front portion of this character. Complete the pass. Create another hue saturation adjustment layer. Press colorize. I will choose a warmer color. So I have a warm ambient lights for the front and cooler ambient lights for the back. Press A for the direct selection tool. Fine tune the ambient light area. Go to the property, choose the mask. Change this to 30 pixel. That will soften the edges of the ambient light. Move this hue saturation down. Next, create another layer. This is going to be the background. I'll just choose black and white, gradient tool, choose the basic gradient from foreground to background. Choose a linear gradient, click and drag from the top all the way down. What you notice is that these adjustment layers also adjust the background as well. To prevent that from happening, select these three layers. Choose new group from layers. The body, okay. Move this up below all of the adjustment layer. So click on the adjustment layer, hit this button. This will limit the adjustment to one layer below, which is the body group. Then do the same thing with this layer. Then do the same thing with this layer. Now all of the extra color adjustments are hidden. Notice that an arrow is pointing towards the body group. And then the body group has an underline on the name. Next, create a shadow. Press P for the pen tool. Click, drag. Press A for the direct selection tool. Modify the shape. Create a new adjustment layer using the level adjustment. Darken the area. Click the mask. Increase the softness of the mask. Make the shadow a little bit darker. The advantage of creating adjustment layers using passes is that you can make changes so easily. Keep in mind that you can also use a color layer like this to adjust color. Lock transparency. Press B for the brush tool. Choose a color. ping in the ambient light. But using the adjustment layer is definitely more flexible. That concludes the Photoshop technique for this character.